3, 2, 1, and liftoff.
Remember the countdown? At the time, 2 years ago, it all seemed so natural, so easy. 73 seconds later, we found out it was anything but routine. In one fateful moment, time almost stood still, as we all wondered, what went wrong?
We didn't know immediately what had happened, but I could tell that there was no chance that any of them came out alive from that explosion.
That explosion on January 28, 1986, is one Marvin and Betty Resnick of Encinitas will never forget. Their daughter, mission specialist Judy Resnick, was one of seven astronauts to die in the Challenger accident.
No matter how much you grieve, it won't do any good. It won't bring them back. So I just have to accept it.
But while they accept the loss, the tragedy, they also cherish the memories. Their home is like a memorial to Judy and the Challenger.
Now you have all of these prominently displayed. Isn't it kind of tough walking by these day after day?
Well, you get used to them. We have them up here, and we look at them just to remind us of little Judy.
Many times, it seems better to remember than forget. In fact, many women remember Judy. She was one of the first female astronauts, one of the first women to experience weightlessness. She's a great inspiration for those trying to break into male-dominated fields.
What would she tell them?
That there was. If they would study hard in school and work hard, there was a chance for them.
She always encouraged scholarship. She says, work hard, study hard, and you're bound to succeed.
Judy's success and courage, and that of the other astronauts on board the Challenger, was eulogized by singer John Denver not long ago.
She was flying for me. She was flying for everyone. She was trying to see a brighter day for each and everyone.
Sometimes it's kind of tough to watch because it shows the life of the astronauts and their hopes and aspirations, and just like that it can finish.
Perhaps in one sense, but not in so many others. A letter to the Resnicks from some good friends seems to sum it up the best. Gone is the Challenger, but not the challenge. No doubt Judy Resnick and the other shuttle astronauts would have agreed.
They were flying for me. They were flying for me. They were flying.